like about shoulder rest. So when you play violin like I do, I mean 3 hours a day at minimum, you don't want to be, you don't want your neck going forward or squeezing down. It'll if you have a pinched nerve in your neck, you're gonna create a lot of pain in your hands. The nerves leaving your spine to your arms get pinched, and there's a lot of burning. And for me, it's triggered by driving, but it's caused by prolonged hours in a day where your head is not, you know. For dancers, they always tell you to keep a string at the top of your crown, like pulling your head up to keep it straight, and your chin should be tucked in, you know, not like that or like that. A lot of people are literally, if you just go out and look how people walk, you know, a lot of them are hunched over. So try always to keep your shoulder blades together and push down in the back, and then your chin tucked in. That's a really quick way of checking your posture. Well, I was using this for a while. It's a Comford, with a D, Comford violin shoulder cradle, and it, I don't know if it's Comford or Comfort, but online it says with a D, and it's $70. Not cheap. It's pretty heavy. This thing is over half a pound. It's got to be like 12 ounces. Anyway, I used it because it was very secure, 4 feet. It didn't fall off, and it has pretty good height. But it's heavy, and when you play for hours a day, that weight is kind of a drag. I recently got today this new rest from, it's a wolf, Forte Primo, and it's very lightweight. It's got to be about 6 ounces, 5 or 6. It's also flexible, and these are adjustable, and you can get it very high. There's a little extension piece you can add there. That'll raise that up. So if you have a long neck and your chin rest is high, but you're still you have to push down and keep it secure, this worked really well. So you put on these feet and you put it at an angle that fits your posture. So I'm not expert on this. Go for that angle, and then I put it kind of over there. I know a lot of people want your violin to touch the collarbone, but I don't particularly enjoy that extra sound coming through my skeleton. So I haven't exactly figured out the exact angle I'm going to use, but I do think this is definitely better than the Comford violin shoulder rest because it's lighter, a lot lighter. It's actually higher, and I believe that I can keep my, again, you want your shoulder blades together and down, your chin in, and you want to imagine that string at the top of your head, so that's how you know you're keeping good shoulder posture, not bent over like that. That's terrible. You ever see these guitar players are like that? Oh my god. Anyway, to not pinch your nerve, or if you have one, to not get symptoms from it, try keeping your head at a straight natural angle. So I find this promising, although I have to figure out the ideal. You see, this feet just came off because I have to adjust it. You can bend it and figure out what you need to get that so that these stay on. I may not have a right, but I do think, it's pretty secure. I think the Wolf Forte Primo, you can get that at Char for, it's definitely significantly cheaper than the Comford and others. Let's see how it works on the daily 5 to 6 mile fiddle walk. And another health tip for your ears, is if to get a really good mute when you're playing. I'm also going to change the strings to be quieter, because I don't, old time people like the steel core, but I'm going to go synthetic for gypsy jazz. These metal mutes, they're super heavy. It's like having an electric violin without the amp on. It's so muted. So you really, if you're playing for hours and your ears start ringing, this is a great, the all metal mute. All right, good. So much for violin playing health. Have a great